Community TV's 2021 Medicine Hat Municipal Election coverage is sponsored by local businesses that support your access to relevant election information. The sponsors do not endorse the candidates or their ideas.
Hi there, I'm Roger McClary. I'm running for City Council on October 18th. My platform is concerning our long-term planning with city government. I would like to see some wealth projects introduced, including geothermal, electricity generation, and geothermal for home heating and cooling and hot water. These are expensive projects, but they do justify themselves in terms of the large price tag. Your savings could be up to 75% in your utility bills just from the home geothermal heating. And now that I plan to do on a community level, so that the price for one hole in the ground that heats your water is split between many, many homes. This will bring the overall cost much, much lower. The other things that, with which I'm concerned are tenants' rights. I've been getting complaints nonstop about certain tenants' issues and how tenants have no ability to do anything about serious concerns. This has resulted in some very serious consequences for Medicine Hat tenants. I'd also like to see that the police service and our firefighters are given benefits and or services that will help them with mental health. I think this is a crucial thing for those careers. I know people in that business, and it's a very, very difficult job. I'd like to discuss perhaps looking at new, more effective and safer equipment for these brave police and firefighters. I think that pretty much sums up my campaign.
Creating content like this would be impossible without local sponsors like Animal World. Head over there and see Rob at Animal World on Dunmore Road. Get some pet food. Lucky's Grit Dip. I just tried the new Buffalo Ranch and I love it. McBride's Bakery. Everybody knows them. You know where they are. They've done great things for the community and they have the legendary Big Elvis Donut. Sponsoring Community TV's content is a cost-effective return on investment for your business and a great way to show that you care about the community. So if you'd like to get your logo here, please contact me. My email is tom@comtv.ca.
Well, what makes you feel like part of this community?
Well, I've lived here for over 5 years, and I ran a small retail business on Aberdeen and Forth. Being retail, I got to meet the entire Southeast Hill community, and really I fell in love with this city because of running that business. I think we all see eye to eye. We're all good people. We want the best for our neighbors, and I hope to take that viewpoint to council.
Can you tell me the name of the business?
It was Rogers Fine Tea.
Right on. This is sort of one of the taboo ones that I think a lot of the other places won't ask, but for some reason I feel like it's maybe still relevant or always relevant, but Medicine Hat thinks it's relevant, so I wanted to ask, what is your religion, and do deities play any role in your decision making?
Well, actually, I'm an agnostic. I do not deny the existence of God, but I haven't found God myself. I believe that in decision making, I'll take in an unbiased manner opinions from anyone, and if their ideas and suggestions are good, those will be considered very carefully. But religion isn't my thing, in any big way. I'm a scientist, and most of my spare time is spent researching topics in science.
What's the worst decision that the city's made in the past 5 years? And I would be talking about council. Is there anything that was on the list in recent history that really made you go, oh man, I could have done better? I'll ask it again and we can just like restart if that's cool with you. What's the worst decision this city's made in the past 5 years?
Oh, thanks. I believe that our long-term fiscal planning has been somewhat erroneous. The reliance on hydrocarbon, petroleum, natural gas resources has always been a steadfast part of Medicine Hat's budget. But with Obama encouraging the U.S. to frack everything, natural gas is more than abundant now. And now we're in a game of playing catch up. That's where my geothermal ideas are coming into play. We have to change gears, get people back to work, and start generating money for the city coffers.
No worries. This one I'm calling the pop shove it question because like a pop question, but pop shove it's a skateboard trick. I didn't put it on the list that I sent out to people, but one of my friends contacted me and he said, please ask the city councilors what they think about the skateboarding bylaw. They're not allowed to skateboard downtown. What do you think about that?
Skateboarding and this being a surprise question, I think that I would need to see some data on whether it's safe. Or whether it is not. I've never had any problems. I don't have any personal issue with people skateboarding. But just so long as they're respectful of other people and traffic. Nobody wants anyone getting hurt. I mean, depending on how it's presented. Bylaw could be adapted to suit skateboarders' needs.
So this one I've wanted to kind of preface a little bit for people like that. Since I moved here 15 years ago, I've covered a lot of different stories, and every once in a while we get this term that comes up where people say, oh, old boys club. And I don't necessarily think that I knew what it meant when I first moved to Medicine Hat, but I think I'm becoming more familiar with what that means. And to me, it sort of means that there's maybe like sort of groups that all kind of protect each other for their own self-interest, that sort of thing. So my question, just to be kind of cheeky, is how do you think you get into the old boys club?
Well,
or maybe you just want to comment on it.
I worked in the oil industry in Calgary, and at least in geophysics and exploration, there was something that we called an old boys club too. I'm not sure if it's exactly the same, but it tended to be people who were management bound, and it involved the Calgary Petroleum Club, and you would end up having a celebration when you were confirmed as a member, and it was different. I wasn't involved in it. I was involved in the, sort of the more hardcore science end of everything. And and my people, if you will, tended to be, extremely competent. And we were the good guys. And it wasn't so much that old boys were bad. It was that we didn't find them, perhaps as effective as they could have been. Just spending too much time on things that weren't important to their job, I don't think I would be a great fit. I've never been invited, you know, I'm not sure why. I mean, it seemed like quite an honor, actually, you know, to be in that club, and I was good at what I did. But yeah, I'm not really sure, you know, in Medicine Hat, if that's what we're talking about.
Yeah, are there parallels there? Like, do you think there's counselors that are sort of there for, you know, sort of there for the ride because it's kind of like a management position, and they just sort of, well, if I can keep this, that's not bad, and I won't really do too much, but, you know, if I get too involved, then maybe somebody will want me to go, so I'll just, is that sort of similar parallel? Am I making
well,
sense?
Our old boys, you know, they didn't want to tread on one another's toes, and it seemed like, there was some secrecy and stuff, but I can't say, you know, having lived here for 5.5 years that, you know, I'd be unwilling to work with any of, you know, the people. Any of the people who, you know, I assume people know, you know, the council people or whomever, who are involved in this old boys system, and I haven't noticed anything, you know, unusual myself, I can't answer the question, how do you get into the club, because it's just never been a concern.
Okay, fair enough.
That's
okay. Well, what's the local solution for the mental health crisis that's been affecting the community?
I have a friend in Calgary. He works at the Self-Help Center. It's a really interesting organization. It's for people with severe mental illnesses. My friend started an addictions program for his clients, because I guess that's quite common. He said that there's a strong correlation between drug abuse, like any kind, alcohol, nicotine, whatever, and, you know, all the illegal stuff, and mental health problems. So I think that a center here, but maybe not, you know, just for people who have, you know, existing, you know, mental health issues, could all be benefited by something like the Self-Help Center. It's like, I'm having a terrible day, I need help now. Mm-hmm. You can just go, you know, down to the, you know, whatever we call it, and get that help. And if that's with addictions, I think his program has been like remarkably successful. And I think it's been something like it has been set up in Lethbridge as well. And the clients think that this kind of service is absolutely outstanding. They get help when they need it, not on an appointment basis. So,
what was it called again?
The Self-Help Center.
Community TV's election coverage would not be possible without the generous sponsorship of businesses like Gravity Sports. Ben helped me build this tall bike that you might see me riding around every once in a while, and the staff down there know just about everything you could want to know about repairing your bicycle, so bring it down there if you need some help. And of course, Gold Dust Jewelry. Johan and I have been friends for quite a while, and while he's moved out of the retail business, he's still doing custom jewelry out of his home studio. And if you need to get a hold of him, just contact his Facebook page or send him an email, and he'll be able to make you a custom piece of jewelry, just about anything you can imagine, and probably deliver it right to your house. Also want to thank Truckers. 24/7 business on the highway that just about everybody has known for the last 20, 30 years. It's been around longer than I've been around. Truckers Restaurant, it's a great place to stop and have a meal anytime you need one, and it's just like a home-cooked meal. Really special. The staff there are great, and they've always got a cool dessert to try. Sponsoring Community TV's content is a cost-effective return on investment for your business and a great way to show that you care about the community. So if you'd like to get your logo here, please contact me. My email is tom@comtv.ca.
What do you think the City of Medicine Hat's role in the conversation is?
Well, that really is a difficult question. I'm not an Indigenous person, I don't mean to deflect, but in all honesty, I'd like to have a round table some kind of a casual meeting with them in order to find out what they want and then start from there. I think it would be inappropriate for me, not understanding all of the issues that they faced, to make any kind of recommendation without before I consult, and if that does come across my desk, that is how I would handle it.
Like, one of the ones I hear a lot when we do press conferences or whatever, sometimes some people in government, they'll say, I want to recognize the land that I'm standing on or something like that. Do you think that'd be something that you would be interested in doing if you had to address the public outside somewhere, that you'd be like, you know what, I want to find out like where exactly this place is and call it that? What do you think about that kind of sentiment?
I think erecting plaques or monuments, it could be a show of respect. I have absolutely no issue with that. If it's important to Medicine Hat, and I think most people would agree that having some more native presence in terms of maybe art or monuments or plaques, and maybe with some historical information on them, to explain to us what's going on, because I don't know, and if I don't know, I can't, I really can't confidently give you an answer. I'm sorry.
There was a lot of overdoses, especially like with coronavirus. You know, like, people are just inside, and if they had a problem with drugs, then it was like a lot of that to do, I guess. And I know a lot of people overdosed, and that sort of leads us back to this conversation about supervised consumption sites, which we had talked about, I think, 4 years ago in this community. What's your stance on them? Do you think Medicine Hat should have a supervised consumption site where people can go in and take their drug of choice?
That's a really interesting question. I know that landowners and stakeholders there are some who might not benefit from such a supervised injection site, but I feel that there's a likely a way that with some conversations that we could find ways to perhaps compensate businesses or what have you, if that on the location causes some people concern. I have heard a few things, and also it having effects on real estate and that sort of thing that surrounds that area. I actually live just up the street from from the supervised injection site on South Railway, I believe it was.
It never ended up getting open, but was the suggested location, and they had wanted to start there. But
Yeah. I was told that it was open.
It ever opened. I could be wrong too, though.
No,
I mean,
no,
I, but,
no, no. Oh, oh, no, I'm embarrassed.
No, that's
sorry.
Okay.
I never noticed anything odd or anything in my neighborhood, and. But I do think there is a high level of benefit for something like that, because these days it can be you can become addicted to opioids in any time in life or any kind of social group. It could happen to anyone. Yeah. And then when you can't get your substances anymore, then you have to turn to the street, and that's where the danger starts to happen. There, you don't know what you're getting, and being able to test it, and that sort of thing. I mean, this could be your granddad. Your mom, something like that, and who happens to end up in this horrible position. And I don't know that it would be a huge problem, but I would like to think, but I don't have any data again, so I would consider it, but I would like to hear what all the stakeholders have to say about that first, because they might have some very, very valuable insight.
I really liked your point, coming from the perspective of science, of we'd be testing those substances there, which is something that goes largely ignored, that there's a lot of substances floating around that people say is this or that and likely isn't, and that's why people die from it. So, yeah I think that bringing that up is valuable conversation there.
Thank you.
What else do we have here? The conversation about homelessness. I mean, what I've noticed since I moved here is that the rent has gone nothing but up, like real quickly. I was lucky enough to be able to get into the housing market, which is not bad right now, but if you're renting, I mean, it seems a little scary. And then they're saying, well, homelessness, it's not a problem in this city. So I guess my question is, like, how do you define homelessness? Like, if I'm sleeping on your couch because the apartment rent got too high and I'm just going to crash for a little while until I go to Bob's place, like, am I homeless?
Yeah.
Or
well, that's exactly what I was going to bring up. Yeah. I think that you're exactly right. Having any insecurity about having a safe home to go to is, in a very real way, homelessness. If you are couch surfing for, and I was very same term that you chose to use. Your options might end very quickly. How many friends do you have who are willing to do that? I moved here 5.5 years ago. I could probably crash at a couple of people's houses, but as soon as if anything happened, or whatever, it turned out that I wasn't welcome. I'd be worried about that, nonstop. And I think that we right now we have almost the perfect recipe for homelessness. It's some specific complaints I've had about specific landlord companies and that sort of thing, where they give you a great rental price and then they jack it up, and you can barely afford that, and then they jack it up again, and then you have to go to Medicine Hat City Housing and ask for a grant. If you decide at that point, I better move out because I can't have another rent hike. Certain institutions don't return your damage deposit, ever, are known to send you a bill for the rest of your lease. So if you sign your second lease and you're 2 months into it, they send you a bill for the next 10 months as well. Your credit's destroyed, depending on what other conditions were going on in your residence. And I've heard some very, very startling, concerns and seen photos as well of, the evidence of certain horrible situations. If that's not dealt with, people can lose their jobs, and then they're conveniently evicted. It's your life destroyed, in a month or two. To me, that's completely unfair. And that's why tenants' rights was, one of my big concerns. And even enacting bylaws to take some control over mismanagement of tenant relationships on the landlord side. Don't get me wrong. I know that we have the majority of the landlords in Medicine Hat are just great people. I've only heard some issues regarding certain ones, and but somebody has to do something about it. Oh, sorry, and that was a little off. I tangentialized there.
That was sort of the things I wanted to talk about there. Okay. That those are very related issues that we're publicly all over the country. We're homelessness. Don't worry about it. And then all of a sudden, looking at these situations where it's like, wait a minute, is it because everybody's just 1 week away from homelessness? I think it's very relevant what you were saying.
Yeah. Well, I mean, yeah. If you think, just about a normal, everyday guy, good job, lives with his girlfriend or whatever, young couple or something like that, and then the next thing they know, they've got no credit, just oh my gosh,
it's hard to keep the girlfriend when you got no credit. Car away and all that stuff.
Well, I don't know about that. I think they'd both be in the same.
um, let's see, we're just about at the end here. Out of everything we've discussed, is there like a top issue that we haven't sort of hammered down at all? Something that you really bring to the table that nobody else is talking about, or something that is your big issue thing that we haven't touched on at all?
No, at the moment, I'd like to speak further about fiscal management issues, but I think we did a good job of that. But if there's anything else you'd like to know about, my alternative energy and employment sort of, idea.
That stuff sounded really interesting. And my first question that came to mind was like, wow, he's really interested in the geothermal stuff. Does his brother own the geothermal company or something like that?
No, my brother lives in Toronto and doesn't know the first thing about a drilling well. So no conflicts of interest there. And I do really, really try to avoid those. The Right Honorable Monsieur Trudeau got into a lot of trouble from not recusing himself when he should have. And to a lot of Canadians, I think they just went, oh, man,
it's
mean,
too easy to find out these days.
I really think that, as a politician, you have to be very, very careful to be, honest and transparent. And yeah, you're right. These days, I think you would be fairly foolish trying to hide anything. Like, the people are pretty good at finding that out.
They are. And last question is like, what do you think of me, community TV? And if you want to, you can talk about just the landscape of media in general in Medicine Hat. I sometimes think that it's somewhat limited, so I wanted to give you the opportunity to just say whatever you think of what I do, and also if you want to comment on any other media related. I don't know if you've done any other interviews, stuff like that.
No, I haven't done many other interviews, but I think you handled this very well. I think your questions are interesting and clever, which I appreciate. And and to be honest, having another media source, I mean, when you covered those protest rallies, I thought that you were getting some blowback from the crowd, and you handled it like someone who was in a war zone. I mean, you were cool and calm. You knew what you were talking about, and I appreciate your courage and your insight. Thank you.
Thank you, Roger.
Thanks again for watching my Community TV 2021 Medicine Hat Municipal Election coverage. And more of the sponsors of Community TV include Hemptown Rock in downtown Medicine Hat, and Patty's doing big things there. So go see her on Railway in downtown Medicine Hat if you need some glassware, if you know what I mean. And then, of course, if you have ever been accused of something, you need the best defense, and the best defense in Medicine Hat is Yarshenko and Heidinger Law Office. Call my buddy Lyndon Heidinger over there and ask him how he can best defend you. There are plenty more spaces for sponsorships on Community TV, so if you want to see your ad somewhere in this municipal election coverage, just contact me, tom@comtv.ca. Thanks again for watching. We'll be right back.